Good morning, everyone. I'm NBC2 First Alert meteorologist Rachel Duensing, joining you from outside today. So if this sounds a little echoey, that's the reason why. But the reason we're joining you outside is because our experiment that we're going to do to start off our weather lesson for today has the potential to be a little on the messy side if we're not careful. And that's also the case with what we're talking about today, and that's tornadoes. Tornadoes can definitely be messy. They can definitely cause issues if you're not prepared for them. But we're not going to talk about that just yet. We want to start out with the fun stuff, with the experiment. So first of all, I want you to look around your house. I want you to find maybe two plastic bottles. They can be the smaller ones like I have here, your normal water bottle size, or what really works well are those big 2-liter bottles. Those work awesome. So if you have some of those maybe in the recycling that you haven't recycled yet, you can grab those out and make your own pet tornado with them. So find your bottles of water or your empty bottles, I should say. And then you also want something to be your debris. And so debris is typically dirt. Sometimes, unfortunately, it's people's houses. It's things like that that gets sucked up in the tornado. We're not going to be doing anything like that with our debris. You can search around your house for some glitter, maybe some food coloring, or I raided my bathroom and I found some old eyeshadow that's sort of loose and looks a little glittery. So that's what I'm going to use for my debris. If you don't have any of that, don't worry. You don't need it. It just makes the funnel that we're creating a little bit easier to see, much like tornadoes in real life. Sometimes they can be hard to see until they touch the ground and they start spinning up all that debris, the dirt, the grass, and unfortunately sometimes buildings and things like that. So make sure you have that if you have it. If you want to maybe stay a little on the less messy side, you can grab a funnel if you have one of these as well to make pouring in the water a little easier and pouring in whatever glitter or debris you're using. But we also want to make sure that those two bottles get put together in a pretty easy way. So if you have some duct tape, I have a big roll right here. That's a good thing to use because we want to make sure these are secure, because that's the potentially messy part, is as we put these two bottles together, we spin the water around inside them to create that vortex, that tornado. We don't want water spilling out, right? We don't want to have mom, dad, grandma, grandpa having to clean up all the water off the floor. So if you can step outside to the lanai or maybe do this in the kitchen, that's probably a really good idea. So let's get started. Okay, so I have one of my bottles filled about halfway with some water. If you want to, you can fill it about 3/4, but you do want to make sure that you have some space. Now, the other thing you want to do is make sure your other bottle is completely empty, because eventually we're going to put them on top of each other just like that. I had a little bit of water left in this one. This is why it could be messy. You're already getting some water drips on you. But eventually, you're going to put these two bottles on top of each other, just like this, tape them together, and that's how we're going to create our vortex. Now, this is the time where if you have any glitter or some dye, food coloring, whatever it is, you can go ahead and put it in there now. Okay, so my eyeshadow didn't work very well. But again, you don't need to put anything in the water. It just makes it look a little easier to see. So the next thing we want to do is find the other empty bottle. And then you want to, remember we said it before, put one on top of the other and tape them together. Let's see if I can do this one-handed. I may have to do a bit of a balancing act here. All right, so we've got some tape on here. It's probably a good idea to do at least 2 layers of tape, because eventually we're going to flip this over. And again, this experiment has the potential to be a little messy and we don't want water to go everywhere. So if you have a little bit of extra tape, maybe put another layer on there just to be safe, make sure we're not covered in water. Okay. I've got my two bottles taped together. I've got a little bit of glitter in there. Again, if you don't have any, it's okay. It's just not gonna be as easy to see. And so now, here's the trick. We're gonna flip this over and make sure that we don't get rained on. Make sure that we don't have any water dripping on us. Okay, so we don't. So now we get to proceed with the rest of our experiment and make our tornado in the bottle. So what you want to do is do exactly what I did before. Flip it upside down so that the part with the water is facing up. But as you do that, I want you to spin it. I want you to make a vortex. I want you to be the tornado so that way we can see exactly what's going on. Okay, are you ready? Go. Can you see it? Do you see the tornado? Let's do it one more time. You just made yourself a pet tornado. You just made yourself a tornado in the bottle. And you can keep this and think about it anytime you want to remind yourself about tornadoes. But of course, you want to make sure that you have some good layers of duct tape on there, because mine wasn't as secure as I thought, and my hands are definitely a little wet with the water leaking out. Now, if you don't have any leftover bottles of water, but maybe you have something like this that's sort of a smaller glass jar, you can do something very similar. So again, you just want to fill it up with water, maybe about halfway or so. Put in some debris, some glitter, some food coloring, or again, you don't have to if you don't have anything around the house. But this is going to work a little bit differently. Instead of turning it upside down, we are going to just spin it in a circle, and you can still see that vortex turn. So we've got a bunch of different options for you to have that pet tornado, and you just think back on it anytime we study tornadoes. Okay, so tornadoes in bottles and jars are all sorts of fun, but in real life, they can cause a lot of damage. So that's why these are fun. Real life tornadoes are not so fun. So we're going to take some time right now and learn about real tornadoes, not the ones that you can keep as pets in jars. Tornadoes are violently rotating tubes of air that come down from a thunderstorm to the ground. In order for them to form, you need what's called wind shear, or a change in the winds from the ground to the upper levels of the atmosphere. That wind shear creates a vortex that is horizontal, so it's not touching the ground yet. In order for that vortex to make it to the ground, it needs something to lift it. Most of the time, that's a strong updraft or strong winds blowing into a storm. That will tilt it until it's up and down. As soon as that vortex hits the ground, it's then called a tornado. You've probably heard the phrase Tornado Alley, so what is it? Tornado Alley is a location in the United States where tornadoes are more likely to form because, especially during the summer, weather conditions are just right. This area in red is usually where we think of Tornado Alley, but over the last few years, it's been slowly shifting south and east, which basically means that more of the United States are dealing with tornadoes than in previous years. Tornadoes form when warm, moist air from the Gulf of Mexico moves north and interacts with cool, dry air from the north, warm, dry air from the southwest, and strong cold fronts are then formed. Those fronts are the lift for the storms to get going, and tornadoes can sometimes form out of those thunderstorms. We of course get tornadoes here in Florida, but they're more common in the panhandle and in the northern part of the state. Tornadoes in Florida are usually weaker than in Tornado Alley, but they can still cause a lot of damage. Florida usually has tornadoes when a tropical system moves close by or when a waterspout moves onshore. Just like the tropical systems we deal with here in Florida, some tornadoes are weak while others are strong. The scale that we use to measure tornadoes is called the Enhanced Fujita Scale, or EF scale. It's named after Dr. Ted Fujita, who created it. It ranges from EF0 to EF5, with 5 being the strongest and most devastating. EF5 tornadoes technically have winds greater than a Category 5 hurricane, but it's important to remember, hurricanes can last days, while tornadoes usually only last minutes. Hurricanes are also much larger than tornadoes. Okay, friends, I hope you learned a little something about tornadoes, how they form, where they're more likely to form, and of course, how to make a fun pet tornado in a bottle. If all else fails, you can always do that fun experiment, fun crafting time while you are stuck learning at home. But I hope you enjoyed today's weather lesson, and stay tuned this afternoon for the next